Uber for haircutters might fail, but guy who does iOS development or girl who does iOS development will survive way past any. You've heard that it's important to test your cold email subject lines to get an 80% open rate. And we've been able to achieve that pretty consistently for our clients selling into the top companies, billion-dollar brands. So how do we do that? The trick is to test a new subject line every 10 emails. The hardest part for us was coming up with these subject lines. But lucky for you, we have 50 plus subject lines in a Google Doc that you can test with your cold email campaigns. And best part, you can have that for free. To get this list of 50 plus email subject lines, go over to experiment27.com/subject. Again, that's experiment27.com/subject. In this video, I want to talk about the 6-step plan that you can use to start a startup. First of all, what is a startup? I consider a startup any sort of business. Some people think a startup means a tech startup, like you're trying to do an app or you're trying to run a software company, which we actually run a software company, Simple Apps, where we do some Shopify applications in a software as a service format. But a startup can also be like our other company, X27, which is a B2B marketing agency where we help people book meetings with billion-dollar brands and we've closed more than $10 million in sales. Or a startup can be literally anything that makes you the money you need to live the life you wanna live. That's it. You wanna live anywhere? You wanna do anything? Then a startup can help you do that. Or you want to support your family or help your parents retire, anything like that, a startup can also help you there. So let's talk about it. What are the 6 steps to start a startup? Number one, create an idea. And we've talked about this a lot on the channel before, how to come up with a business idea. Basically, what you want to do is look at your past jobs, look at job boards, think about other business concepts, and try to create a one-sentence business idea. And I'll give you an example. For X27, it's Experiment 27 books meetings for your company with billion-dollar brands. We help companies book meetings with the Fortune 500. That's it. Within Simple Apps, we have WhatsApp chat. And the business idea for that is integrate WhatsApp messaging into your Shopify store. That's it. And what is important to note about these business ideas is these aren't crazy new ideas. This isn't like Uber for dogs or Uber for haircutters. When I was at this digital agency in New York, every single client that came in for a long time was just Uber for something. And I can't think of a single one that succeeded. However, the businesses that do succeed are the ones like the agency I was working in. The people that are providing basic services that people need. So for instance, Uber for haircutters might fail, but guy who does iOS development or girl who does iOS development will survive way past any Uber for dogs sort of tire fire of a business. Trash idea, by the way. Uber for dogs, come on, what does that even mean? So, step one is create an idea. The easiest way to create an idea is just to think of an idea, whatever speaks to you. So for instance, if I was gonna start a business, let's say it's a landscaping company, done. Or I'm just looking around here. Try to think of a service, something you can provide right away. Maybe I'll sell towels. I'm looking at a towel, maybe I'll sell bottles of water. That's as far into the business concept as you have to think right now. So now step two is sell that idea. Let's say you do want to sell water bottles. How do you go about it? And actually you can see this in depth. We did a cold calling experiment where we came up with a business idea to sell nuts in India, wrote the entire script and had cold callers reach out and made sales. As easy as that. Now, what I would do if I was trying to sell water bottles is first, I am a guy whose background is in business to business marketing, not business to consumer, so I wouldn't worry about Facebook ads or anything like that. So what I would do is pick an office building and start cold calling the businesses that are in that office to sell them water bottles. And I would sell them in bulk, like case after case. And honestly, I'd either knock out some contracts that way and make some money, or they would tell me that they don't need water. And then I can ask them what they do need and I can move on to step three in the process, which is change based on feedback. What? Hey, we don't buy water in single bottles, sir, they might say, but we do buy 5-gallon jugs and we buy about 40 of those a month. Right now we're spending $6 on each of these. If you can get them for $3, maybe we'll buy from you. Now, if I hear that a couple times, first of all, I'm gonna try to sell the original idea a couple times first. And if I hear the same sort of thing, like maybe these big office building companies are only buying 5-gallon jugs, Well, guess what? I don't need this shit. I think I just woke everybody else up in this entire house. I'm gonna sell 5-gallon jugs. That's it. That's as quick as you're pivoting off of these business ideas. Nothing is set in stone at this point. Then the next step is sell again. Cold call. Hey, I sell 5-gallon jugs of water to office buildings. Typically, I know you guys are paying. Well, I would actually start with a question. I'd be like, hey, we sell 5-gallon jugs of water to office buildings, and we can beat your current pricing on anything you have. What are you paying right now for a 5-gallon jug of water? And then they're either gonna hang up on you or they'll say, you know, hey, we pay $5 to $6 a gallon. Then you say, well, I've got contacts in place that can get you the same quality of water for $3. Wanna test us out? Buy a couple? And then you see what they say. They might give you more feedback, like asking you who you've worked with in the past. And in order to get past that, you either have to lower the prices further, give them a free gallon, or talk about how great the water is again, maybe stop by their office and sell it. Or they'll buy, and that'll be it. And that brings us to the next step. If they say no, or they give you reasons why they don't want to buy your 5-gallon water jugs right now, which is improve the idea and raise prices. Now that you know people are buying your thing, your 5-gallon water jugs or whatever business concept it is, try to get the price up to $6 per 5 gallons, maybe even $8 per 5 gallons, now that you understand your customer, and improve the idea. Maybe they want to buy other things in addition to the 5-gallon jugs that nobody's thought of before. Maybe pairing coffee and water is a good idea. You can ask your customers. Maybe pairing little snacks and water is a good idea. Maybe you are just a supplier for office supplies. Maybe you're selling them pens and paper and whatever it is. Once you're talking to customers, once your startup has started, once there's revenue being generated and it's not just a business in your mind, you've got ultimate freedom to grow it and scale it from there. Then the final step is repeat. You can either take it all the way back to the idea stage or sit on that last point over and over again, improving the idea, adding more things to your business that you're selling, improving your product, raising your pricing, and continuously getting better and better and better and better until you're living the life you want to live. Then you chill. That's it. That's not one of the steps. Chilling's not one of the steps. But I mean, if you're done working, stop working, right? So that's that. To review, how to start startups: create an idea, sell that idea, change based on feedback, sell the idea again, improve the idea and raise prices, and repeat. By the way, if you want the system that we're covering in this video as a free checklist, grab the link in the description. You can have a PDF of everything we talked about. Thanks for watching the video. Feel free to comment below. What are you gonna try? What is your business? Make a decision and comment below and then work on it. Actually try to sell it. Follow this process and let me know how much money you made. Or if it failed, let me know if it failed and we'll brainstorm why in the comments. Like this video to encourage this type of content on YouTube. Subscribe for more content like this. We do videos 3 times a week all about sales, lead generation, how to be a better entrepreneur, how to live your best life, et cetera, et cetera. I'm Alex Berman. Thanks for watching.